Let's learn IIB. Today, I will explain grouping and merging concepts in IIB using eSQL. Consider a scenario where you get an XML file with hundreds of products such as LG mobiles, LG refrigerator, so on. Now, your requirement is to merge all products from LG into one bucket, all Samsung phones and other electronic devices from Samsung should go to one queue as big message. Next, all products should be grouped and should go to LG queue as well. Samsung to Samsung queue, LG to LG queue, but they have to be merged. I will reuse an existing product from my GitHub repo for this task. Link in description. The flow for this requirement is simple with only three nodes: MQ input to acquire data, MQ output to deliver data, and eSQL to process data. That's the major nodes. Pass-through is only used to consume the exception list in case of any errors. We don't want the message to keep on looping within the MQ input node. That is why we have to create this catch handler. We create input queue and multiple output queues using run mqsc shell. Destination list will be used to send to multiple output queues. You see input and output structures on screen. Here, two output is shown, but we should design a solution that can handle hundreds of brands and hundreds of queues. We have to merge Samsung products together before sending it to Samsung queue. Pause the video, take a minute and see if you can figure out how the algorithm is functioning. Why do I need two for loops? There is no if-else logic for Samsung and LG. Then how is this working? Now do you see the logic after looking at the variables in debug mode? We first iterate over all the products and save them in environment under buckets of the respective brands such as LG and Samsung. All LG products are separated to LG brand. All Samsung products are separated to a bucket called Samsung under environment. We then loop over the brands and send each brand message to its own queue using destination list. This is a final result. One XML with four products is broken into two XMLs with two products each. Samsung products are grouped and sent to Samsung queue. LG products are grouped and sent to LG queue. Beauty of this solution is that you don't have to specify the names Samsung and LG in your code. You don't have to write if-else logic. Let me know in comments if you know of any other interesting problems like the one shown in the video.